everybody on YouTube land, Jamie Powell back for another film review today, and we're talking about the film Tenet. But this film is dedicated to one of my subscribers who very kindly sent me some things last month, and he got in touch and said, I'd love to see your review of this movie. So this is for you, my friend, Derek Fairline. Here's your name. I hope I pronounced that correctly. So then, Tenet. What is it? Well, Tenet is a new film directed by Christopher Nolan. It's a big blockbuster movie, and it stars Robert Pattinson and... That would be John David Washington, you dipstick. Which is Denzel Washington's son. And what's it about? I haven't got a fucking clue. I actually could follow it to a certain point. It's about this guy who has to go on a very top secret mission sort of thing, where, and it's all about time bending and his action. But I'm not going to go into too much detail, because I think it's a film you need to go and see in blind, and you probably will need, a lot of people will need to see it a few times to get the full grasp of it. But so it is a brilliantly filmed film. It's a very well made film, and the performances are all great. There's not one bad note. This pacing is okay. There are some slow moments here and there that could have done with it. It is a bit too long for its runtime, and I don't know. I found it a bit too long, but there is some amazing work in here. The acting, like I said, is great. There's not one bad note. The direction is spot on. The filmmaking, the editing, the effects, the action, everything is top notch. It's just the plot is very convoluted, a bit too clever for its own good, and it's quite jarring. But I could follow it to a certain point, but it just felt like they need a bit more characterization, a bit more character development, I should say, a bit more understanding of what the hell's going on, and not everything, the loose ends, it didn't quite tie up. But overall, I actually quite enjoyed it. I thought it was a pretty good film. Too long, and a bit mind-bending for some. But for me, I enjoyed it for what it was. It wasn't one of Nolan's best, which I am in between a few on those. I might do a top 10 Nolan films or whatever soon, maybe. We shall see. But it's not a bad film at all. In fact, he has never done a bad film. But this is one of the weaker films, in my opinion. I thought, like I said, the performances were all great, and the music, it was fine. At times it was really good, and at times it was a bit mediocre. I will say one thing, it was too freaking loud. My goodness, we saw it in iSense, and it was deafening. Me and the wife were coming out, oh my fucking head. It was deafening. But hopefully on Blu-ray, it might not be so bad. So, what would I rate this film out of 5? Well, personally, like I said, of all my negatives aside, I really did enjoy it. And I thought Kenneth Branagh, I forgot to mention, Kenneth Branagh as the villain was superb. Fantastic villain. Terrifying. The best performance in the whole film for me. He stole it for me. But like I said, everybody was good. So, back to the rating. Out of 5, I would go 4. Yes, that's quite high. About 8 out of 10. It's very good. It needs repeated watching, but it's not his best. But it is still a very good film, and I really did enjoy it for what it was. But it just lacked that something special. So that was my opinion of Tenet. That was for Derek. Hope you enjoyed the review, mate. All the best to you and the family. And thank you to everybody out there who watched this review. Please like, share, and subscribe. More videos coming soon. Stay safe, play safe, and I'll see you again soon for some more videos. Bye for now.